Tim Ford, lead engineer for Blizzard, wrote a post a few days ago about a new aiming option coming to consoles. It's a complicated post with lots of numbers, and as a result, there's quite a bit of confusion in the comments about what it actually does and if it will fix linear ramp. Well, I'm here to clear up a lot of things and hopefully have a definitive answer here for you today. First, I'd like to address the linear ramp issue and how it is broken. I know I'll get a lot of flack for this, but I disagree with this statement. Just hear me out. Broken to me means unusable, for which I can say that linear ramp as it is now is totally usable. Why do I say this? Because I've been using linear ramp exclusively for over a month now, and I actually prefer it to dual zone. And some of you may know that I actually really like dual zone. The key to getting it to work is using a low sensitivity. Currently I'm using 40-30, a far lower number than my previous 80-50 with dual zone. The graph that Tim Ford posted when comparing exponential ramp to linear shows us how even at the very start of linear ramp, your movement will be pretty fast even with small movements. So if you have a high sensitivity, it will be brutal for you. Now the downside is your turn speed suffers greatly, but tracking is still so much easier in my opinion with this than the other two aiming options. Of course, you're free to disagree, that's fine. I'm totally open to linear ramp not being exactly where it's supposed to be if that's the case. But unusable? That's hardly true. With that out of the way, I'd like to go over the post and explain exactly what Tim Ford is talking about here. He says, "I'd like to clear up some confusion about the difference between linear and exponential ramp, as well as announce some new options you can leverage to fine-tune your aim. I've read a few posts that assume exponential ramp yields a exponentially higher turn rate than linear when the aim stick is fully deflected. This is a reasonable assumption, since an exponential curve will yield a higher result than a linear curve for values greater than 1. However, the goal of exponential ramp is to map a sensitive aim stick to a restrained aim value. We achieve this goal by mapping linear input to exponential values over the range from 0 to 1. The exponential ramp values we are concerned with fall into the region of the curve box in the following image." So again, what he is saying here is that there are people that make the assumption that exponential ramp will make you turn faster than linear ramp when the joystick is fully extended or deflected. Now in theory this is true, but in real life this is actually false, and I think that's why many people are confused about this. He states that the goal of exponential ramp is to take a sensitive aim stick, linear ramp, and make it manageable, not making it actually surpass linear ramp's capabilities, which the first graph shows, and I think that's what people think how it works currently, therefore think expo ramp goes faster than linear ramp. He explains that expo ramp only surpasses linear ramp's speed when the input value is greater than 1, and as he states several times in the post, the values of your joystick movement max out at 1. So when you move your joystick from the center to the outer edge, you're only dealing with values between 0 and 1. You're never actually going higher than that. Therefore, if you have, say, a 50 sensitivity on your joystick, whether it's expo ramp or linear ramp, when the joystick is fully extended, they are actually turning at the same speed. The difference between them is that they approach that speed very differently. Without going too deep into this, linear ramp uses your joystick's dead zone, called scaled radial technique, to determine your turn speed. This is the raw input that everyone likes linear ramp for. No filters or anything. It's literally a representation of your dead zone. And what they do is convert this linear line's numbers to expo ramp numbers, like a linear ramp input of 0.25 will map to an exponential input of 0.03125. A linear ramp input of 0.75 will map to an exponential ramp input of 0.4871. Exponential ramp scales this value roughly by a power of 2.5. And that's how you obtain the curve you see here on the graph. They say the reason the power is 2.5 is because this is roughly what Call of Duty uses. This allows your aim to be fine-tuned much easier with small movements while still having good turn speed when the joystick is fully deflected. Dual zone is similar to expo ramp in some ways, except it's on the extreme side. You have a very low sensitivity, and once you reach the edge of the joystick movement, it bursts into high sensitivity, with not much smoothing in between the way expo ramp does it. However, expo ramp doesn't seem to be able to reach the extreme lows and high sensitivities of dual zone, so there's definitely trade-offs with all of these. The new option that's being added to the game is going to be a slider called aim ease in. I know many are confused about what this does and if this fixes linear ramp. Well, my answer to this is no, it doesn't fix linear ramp. But I also feel that linear ramp is not broken, so this doesn't upset me that much. What this essentially does is it gives you your own custom exponential ramp curve by starting with the default raw input of linear ramp, then scaling the curve to your liking and turning it into expo ramp. A lower number on the side will give you only a slight curve and will still give you a linear ramp feel. A high number will give you a version of expo ramp that is stronger than if you just switch to the expo ramp option that's already in the game. Now, Tim Ford says that this option is compatible with dual zone and expo ramp, but you should expect a fairly compressed aim curve if you slide it all the way up. Now, with all that said, I think there is a fundamental problem with all of this. See, after seeing this article and understanding what exactly linear ramp and expo ramp do, then in theory, expo ramp should be the best aiming system and we shouldn't need anything else. So why was dual zone and linear ramp added at all? I decided to do some quick play matches with McCree using expo ramp, and after a couple of matches, it became quite clear to me that Overwatch is not Call of Duty. Obvious, I know, but think about it. Expo ramp and the new aim ease in option are basically the aim system that Call of Duty uses, which is regarded as one of the best console aiming systems. So why does it not work with Overwatch too well? Well, essentially in Call of Duty, your character has two aim sensitivities. One when you're hip firing and the other when you aim down sights. Hip firing allows you to turn and move fast at the cost of accuracy, while aim down sights makes your character move very slow, but you get more accuracy because you essentially lowered your sensitivity by aiming down your gun. So let me ask you this. How many heroes in Overwatch actually aim down sights and have these two separate sensitivities built into them like in Call of Duty? Two. Widowmaker and Ana. You might think Hanzo too, but his strafe is just slowed down, not his turn speed, so it's not exactly the same thing. So do you see what I mean about expo ramp? Now this by itself does not mean expo ramp is useless for any hero that doesn't aim down sights. The big reason I feel expo ramp is not good for Overwatch is because in Call of Duty, when you're shooting at someone and they're shooting back, you're almost standing still. How do Call of Duty players dodge? By going prone or drop-shotting, if that's still a thing, I don't know. And yes, there are the new CODs that use wall running and jetpacks and all that. However, in Overwatch, we have heroes like Genji, Tracer, and now Doomfist. Heroes that are very good at repositioning in the blink of an eye. Tracer pun not intended. So expo ramp is missing that snappy feeling that linear ramp offers, so you're able to track and follow these very fast targets, even at low sensitivities. If expo ramp works for you, then by all means. But for me, I just can't track as well with it as linear ramp when it comes to fast moving targets. So in short, if you feel linear ramp is broken, then this new option will not change your mind. And if you like expo ramp, then this option should make you drool with excitement. Because all it is a way for you to create your own custom exponential ramp curve. Hope you enjoyed. Be sure to follow me on Twitch where you can talk with me live and ask any questions or just have a fun conversation while hanging out with me. That's it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to share, like, and subscribe to the channel. My name is Chit, and I approve this message.